In this video, I'm going to talk about the syn dihydroxylation reaction. Alkene in presence of the osmium tetroxide and hydrogen peroxide gives a syn diol. So this oxygen atom from the osmium tetroxide attacks this particular carbon atom here. So this double bond break and the pi electrons from this double bond attacks the oxygen here. And this double bond between the oxygen atom and osmium also breaks and leaves the electrons as a lone pair on the osmium atom. So we form this particular bond here where two carbon atoms form two bonds with the oxygen atoms. So our hydroxylation comes from the hydrogen peroxide here and attacks this osmium atom here. So as a result, this double bond will break and the electrons will shift towards the oxygen atom here. So this oxygen atom will be left with a negative charge on it, and later on, as this is a reversible reaction, so this will try to reform a double bond here and also can kick off this OH group here, or this bond can break and leave the electrons onto this oxygen atom. So this oxygen atom will be having a negative charge on it and will come closer to the water molecule and will grab a hydrogen atom, and this particular bond between oxygen and hydrogen will break and it will leave the electrons onto the oxygen atom. Now definitely will form this particular intermediate here, and another hydroxylation will come and will attack the osmium atom in order to form a bond, and this double bond will break and leave the electrons on this oxygen atom. So this negative charge on the oxygen atom will try to reform a double bond here and it can kick off the OH group here, or this bond can break and leave the electrons on this oxygen atom. So we'll be having a negative charge on this oxygen atom here, and it will come closer to the water molecule and will grab a hydrogen atom here. So this bond will break and will leave the electrons onto this oxygen atom, and we'll form our final product here. Two hydroxy groups are added across the double bond, and as both the oxygen atoms are coming from a single osmium tetroxide molecule, it's normally are adding from the same side. So this is a syn addition. And also we are forming a reduced form of osmium here, because in osmium tetroxide, the oxidation number of osmium is +8. But in this particular case, our oxidation number of osmium is +6. So this is a reduced form of osmium here. Now, this osmium will react with the NMO, that means N-methylmorpholine N-oxide, and it will regenerate the osmium tetroxide here, and also N-methylmorpholine morpholine as a base. So in this particular reaction, you can clearly say that the osmium tetroxide is acting as a catalyst. And you have to remember that osmium tetroxide is a toxic compound, and you have to add this a very small catalytic amount. So, and actually in this reaction, we are consuming our hydrogen peroxide, and osmium tetroxide is acting as the catalyst. So I will see you guys next time.